thank all for coming out tonight, and we appreciate your support for Jared and special occasion. We'll start this program now. Thank you.
Sometime you need to have him explain to you what his project was, his Eagle Scout project, and what an accomplishment that was. And it wasn't something that was trivial, it was something that was proved to be very important to the city. There are many who will thank him for that. Again, I want to express my appreciation to Jared for his diligence, and let you know that I know that he will go far in life. This Eagle Scout Award is just a stepping stone for him. And
cold boys and fire up a snow cave. I didn't know that was possible until then. And Jared kind of took over. He directed them and got the cold ones into the trailer. And I don't know what all he did, but he directed everybody that night. And I appreciated that. I needed the help. And all the scout camps are still. It's amazing. I can't think of one time where I got mad at him. He was always there to help. He teased. He liked to tease, especially leaders or the other boys. But he was always there to help and help the other boys and doing what he was supposed to do. And that's maybe got in trouble, things like that. He did. I think back on his experiences, mine and scouting. And I'd like to have him think about the responsibility he now has. It's a great honor. It's been honored today, and he should be honored. But he has a responsibility to carry on now in scouting. Because now he's an Eagle Scout, and that means something. He'll be asked the rest of his life, he'll be asked if he was an Eagle Scout, when he's a missionary. All through his life, he'll be asked that question, and he carries with it not just honor, but responsibility to the principles of scouting. If you think about the scout oath and the scout law, that you have to carry and be an example of those principles the rest of your life. And while there's a lot more expected of you, I mean, you wouldn't expect to have a town wino and people would say, yeah, he was an Eagle Scout. And I challenge you to take that responsibility, and I know you will. You will honor this position and this achievement for the rest of your life. And I'm grateful to have been the leader of Jared's for a while. He was truly a joy to have the troop and to work with. And I say this in the name of Jesus Christ.
About a moment about the purpose of the law of liberty.
As you know, our founding fathers set up this nation and established a wonderful country for which we have a lot to be proud. It talks about the first of all that it is. In James chapter 1, verse 25. But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the word, this man shall be blessed in his deed. As I think about the perfect law of liberty, but I would like to read to you tonight, and Jared, I commend this to you as your father. And I promise you as your father that if you will keep the perfect law of liberty and be not a forgetful hearer or doer, your heavenly Father will pour out blessings upon your head that will be beyond your comprehension. I would like to read you the original perfect law of liberty. Remember our founding fathers, they placed their lives, their fortunes, and their sacred honor, calling upon supreme beings for the rectitude of their intentions. You don't have the liberty and freedom as a scout or as a member of this great church to do whatever you want, but to do what you ought to be doing. And our founding fathers understood that. And rectitude means righteousness. At this time, I'd like to read you the perfect law of liberty. It says, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day, keep it holy. Honor thy father and thy mother. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. And thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. And thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's house, nor thy neighbor's wife, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is thy neighbor's. Brothers and sisters, that is a perfect law of liberty. If you stay true to the perfect law, then we will have happiness in this life and the life to come. As Brother Dan has said, and again, Jared, as a member of this church, you have a duty to God, family, and country, and your duty has just begun to start. You also have another thing coming up here shortly, a mission. You are on your way, and very proud of you. Your mother's very proud of you. Your family's very proud of you. But I want you to publicly know now that all that you are, all that you have been blessed with, is the result of two individuals, your heavenly Father and your mother. I'm grateful to have you as a son. I love you with all my heart. I'm proud of what you've done. And I say this in the name of Jesus Christ. About Jared and how proud he is of having such a son, things like that. We haven't been here too long. We've lived in Dallas for a year and a half. And we've been privileged to live as co-wives while we're miles from New Orleans. By road, something over 3 miles. And from day one, Jared and the rest of the family, but primarily Jared, shall we say, adopted us. Not just a kid. No, I'm talking about that. Anyway, Jared spends a fairly significant portion of his time in our house. If you don't believe me, ask his mom. Well, ask his dad. But ask his mom. And we've gotten to know Jared a little bit that way. We've gotten to know him through scouting as well. One of the things about Jared is it's neat for us because, you know, it feels that comfortable with us. Now, it's not just Jared, David's got his own stash there too. But, you know, David and Jared are two different boys. David, day one, has been willing to sit down and ask us to meet. Not Jared. Not Jared. Jared's different. And, you know, most boys, especially when they're teenagers, have no problem consuming dinner, right? And anything before or after. But Jared, then we found out that his mom had told him he's not supposed to eat away from home if he had a promotion. He's a vegan, so his mom is apparently. And so we thought, okay, we can handle that. And then we found out the real reason. He doesn't buy what we eat. We have vegetables. We have wheat bread. We have things like grapefruit. You know, and we don't have all these other things. We found out about Jared's real treat or something. So if you really want to hang on to Jared, you know what to do. Take a slice of bread. And incidentally, he's come to eat wheat bread, believe it or not. So take a slice of bread and he put a heavy layer of peanut butter on it. And then you get another slice of bread. And then you put another good heavy layer of peanut butter on. And if it's really a real treat for him, you get some marshmallow cream and smear it on it. And he will chow down. Oh, man, does he go after this? Just and so we enjoyed Jared coming over. And we know how to feed him. I don't like to come to feed him. I know what your heart is. It's interesting. He came over a lot last summer. Even when the boys weren't home, our boys, who are Jared and David's age, basically, were gone for much of the summer. But Jared especially kept coming over. Kid came over, and what would he do when he came? Work. Do that. Work. His parents don't believe he went to work home. He'd come over and work. We were putting down saw, he got right in the middle of it. Laying saw. A building deck. Got out there. Don't build that. Anything we wanted, straight it up. It didn't matter what it was. He'd come over and work. We got down there after a while. We always knew when he was coming because Jim's truck is not like most people's truck. He's got the red dots he drives to work, right? He generally puts his ladder on top of it. And he drives the ladder up there all the way. And we live on a dirt road. And there's some horse truck holes in the road. And he was this ladder that will rattle the truck. And so from about a mile away, we can say, Norland Rover! No, I think Jared has his own toothbrush and his own blanket on. Well, everybody turn around and look at it. See, Jared, it's kind of wavy. How many of you have seen him in the morning before today? It looks like it's going to bomb. That says something. He's a good girl.
I mean, he's a student from Denver, he's a football player, and sure, you know. He's a good kid, he puts up with the law, especially our house, my son, right? And when he sits down there, but he's a good example. He's a good example not only for us, but for the other teachers down there. And Dan in particular talked about that. What he's done there. We went on a trip last summer, last spring, just about this time, maybe a couple weeks later, a lake house, all places. We were right in the trail, Catholic National Islands. What a good time. Now, if you've been to Lake Powell, this time of year, it could be fairly warm, I'm having a temperature, at least the high seventies, maybe in the eighties a little bit. But, the boys were satisfied with that. So, at least first one in the morning. It was a cold day. Oh, it did. The boys were fine, they found lots of starch on them. It was bad, actually. He went to Alaska last summer. And he spent, two, 3 weeks there? Something like that. Went to Alaska, and we had the privilege, folks were involved, both of us, and we had the privilege, Beth and I, had the privilege of taking him to the airport to fly out. That was a privilege, it really was. So we stayed, he had an early plane on in the morning, so we stayed at a motel at that time. And now, when I go, it's not personal, we roll this in, what, July, I would guess. They have an outdoor swimming pool. Jared was willing to go swimming. We were quite small. And so, he managed to talk my wife into going swimming, but she didn't have swimsuit. So the two of them were swimming, and Susie and I are sitting on the edge watching. And it was a little interesting. Some other people came out and they climbed out, they were good too. So when Dean was saying more about it, I bet Michael liked to hear the rest of the story. I just talked about it. Jared, I said Jared's a good name for him, and he is, and he does put up with a lot. For years, since our kids were little, when their friends, I'll always give them kids good night. And when their friends would come over and stay with them, their friends always got a kiss. Susie's little girlfriends, Adam and little boyfriends. They didn't always like it, but they got their kisses. Well, they're bigger now, so I don't try to force a kiss on them. But Jared, he just comes over. What's he cheating on? But I think there is no boy with better
These are good things you've been through more part of the quality of man that you He has a great path. Now you come to help. He has a great path. Now you come to help the future great. I charge you, Eagle Scout Lieutenant, to be a leader among men, but lead only toward the best, taking yourself to the highest level of service to God and the fellow man. By so doing, you will leave behind you only a record that every scout that follows will be just as proud. Jared, we now have fame of all the world's accomplishments. The symbol of your success is an eagle badge mounted on your body. Your father is the one who has wisely counseled and advised you. He is your best pal. He will hand the badge to your mother, who will turn the pinnacle for a good heart. She is proud of you as is your father. Never let them be disappointed in you, their lives and their all. Liza, to you as your son is presented, kindly being on your way on the team. You may remind all the scouts to please salute us again, such as being upon and also the audience to stand. And now, Eagle Scout Jared Norman, in recognition of the many hours of patient guidance given by her in your efforts, will you pin over your mother's heart the Eagle's mother's pin?
letters. What's it doing? Move this scarf, Jim. You're going to have to add it to this, Jimmy, I'm sure.
Is this a tie class? This is my pen.
This is a tie class. No, this is your pen. This is your tie class, isn't it?
This is my tie class.
Oh. This is
your pen.
Oh, yeah. That's why this is hanging here like this. Mine was on my lapel. I hope I didn't.
I always thought Dad would.
Hi, sweetheart.
He sat on a rather thorny bush.
That kid is so ugly.
He's still not very happy about it.
Ugly kid.
He's going to pick a better perch next time. Yes. I'm the dad of an eagle. I have never flown, but I do have an eagle son.
Show me, Jen. Show mommy. Jennifer. Jen. Show mama.
It's puppy.